Hey guys, today we'll discuss about pharmacology of proton pump inhibitors. So these are the group of drugs which are used in conditions with hyperacidity, which means they are inhibiting acid secretion in our stomach, right? So first we'll discuss the names of the drugs, then we'll start with side effect, mechanism, indication, effects, side effects, everything, right? So we have some drugs such as omeprazole, dexlansoprazole, pantoprazole, rabeprazole, esomeprazole, lansoprazole. So these are the group of drugs which included in the proton pump inhibitors. So the word itself says they are inhibiting proton pump. So where exactly they will inhibit, how exactly they will inhibit, that's what we'll discuss in this video, right? So first we'll start with pharmacokinetics, then we'll go to mechanism of action, right? So in pharmacokinetics, these drugs are taken orally. They have like injection forms. So for example, I told you some drugs such as pantoprazole. So you can give it in IV also. So whenever you take it orally, what will happen? These group of drugs, they have a special coating on them that is called enteric acid resistant coating. Enteric acid resistant coating, right? So when they have this coat, what will happen? They will escape from the stomach. Means our stomach has acid, right? Whenever I put some medication, whenever I put these proton pump inhibitors into the acid, they are losing their property. So to prevent that, they have this coating. So they will, with the help of this enteric resistant coat, they will escape the acidic contents of the stomach. Then they will reach duodenum. What will happen? From duodenum, it is absorbed. So these absorbed drugs, where it will go, they are then later transported to the parietal cells. So where our parietal cells are located? So we have parietal cells in our stomach. Right. So our stomach has parietal cells. Why it is going to parietal cells? Because parietal cells are the ones which are producing acid, right? So this is how it is transported in our body. Then we'll discuss now about the mechanism of action. So to discuss mechanism of action, we should understand how acid is secreted in our stomach. So if you know how acid is secreted in our stomach, we can easily understand mechanism of action. Right. So I'm drawing a simple diagram for parietal cell here. Let's take, this is the lumen of the stomach. Right. So that way this will be the inner surface. So this inner surface has some receptors. So it has some receptors. For example, it has some receptor for histamine. That is H2 type of receptor. Here there is another types of receptors, that is receptors for gastrin. Right. So we have one more type of receptors, that is acetylcholine receptors. Right. So we have three groups of receptor. This is H2 receptor. This is gastrin receptor. This is acetylcholine receptor, right? So these H2 receptors are stimulated by histamine, right? So whenever histamine stimulates this H2 receptor, what it will do? It will activate, means plus symbol means it will activate enzyme called adenyl cyclase. So what this adenyl cyclase will do? It will convert ATP to CAMP. What is CAMP? CAMP is a secondary messenger of the cell, right? So what happens whenever gastrin comes to stimulate the gastrin receptor, they will allow influx of calcium, means calcium ions are coming in, right? Whenever acetylcholine coming and binding with acetylcholine receptor, it will also allow influx of calcium ions. So calcium ion also is, this is secondary messenger of our cell. CAMP is also a secondary messenger for the cell. what it will do, they will activate, means they will activate protein kinase. Right, so these three will activate protein kinase. Right, whenever the protein kinase is activated, what it will do, it will make our proton pumps. So proton pumps, where they are located? Proton pumps are represented like this: hydrogen and potassium ATPs, H plus and potassium ATPs. What do I mean by ATPs? Means they are using energy, right? So what it will do, it will secrete hydrogen ion into the lumen, means hydrogen ion is coming out and potassium ion is going into the parietal cell. So this protein kinase will do this function. Who is making formation of protein kinase? The receptors, whatever is located on the parietal cells, right? So whenever the histamine or maybe any of the receptor stimulated, they will stimulate secretion of the hydrogen into the stomach lumen, and it will increase the formation of acid. Means it is the last step of acid production in the stomach, right? What are proton pump inhibitors will do? They will come and inhibit this. So PPIs will inhibit proton pump, means they will inhibit the last stage of acid secretion. Means whenever the last stage of acid secretion is stopped, what will happen? Whatever stimulation of histamine, gastrin, acetylcholine, whatever it may stimulate, but there is no proton exchange. Whenever there is no proton exchange, the stomach acidity will decrease and stomach pH will increase. Right? So this way, they will inhibit these proton pumps for about 18 hours. So they have a long duration of action by decreasing the stomach acidity and increasing the stomach pH. Right? So this is the mechanism of action of our proton pump inhibitors. Right? So what is this hydrogen and potassium ATPase? This is a type of protein which is necessary for the transport. Right? So whenever this proton pump is inhibited, acid was not produced. Now we'll discuss about indications. So definitely whenever the acid levels in the stomach are decreased, which means we can use it any condition which is having hyperacidity. So that is Zollinger-Ellison syndrome. Zollinger-Ellison syndrome. So this is a condition where acid production is increased, right? We can use it definitely. Where we can use it? In peptic ulcer. Why we use it in peptic ulcer? Because whenever acid level is decreased, it will allow the stomach wall, I mean the damaged wall, to regrow itself. So it will provide an environment for the growth of the cells which are damaged in the ulcer, right? We can use it in GERD, that is gastroesophageal reflux disease. We can use it in the esophagite. So which type of esophagitis? That is specially erosive type of esophagitis. Erosive esophagitis. Right. So these are some indications. And there is one special indication, like not special indication, which has like good action of the PPIs, that is NSAID induced ulcers. So if you don't know about NSAIDs, I have a video for NSAIDs, you can go and check that out, right? So these NSAIDs, these are the drugs which induce the formation of peptic ulcer. Whenever there is a ulcers that is induced due to NSAIDs, NSAID induced ulcer. What is a special property in this type of ulcer? What it will happen? What is the one of the complication of ulcer? That is bleeding, right? So they will decrease bleeding tendencies. Bleeding tendencies. Right. So these are some indications of our proton pump inhibitor. So once we know indications, we should know the side effects. So we'll discuss about side effect. So side effects, they are like very well tolerated, which means they have very less side effect. But these drugs also have some effects on the drug which is called clopidogrel. So this is a drug. Clopidogrel is a drug. It is used in a cardiovascular patients. What it will do, these PPIs may decrease its absorption. So when they are decreasing the absorption of clopidogrel, the cardiovascular incidents may increase in the patient. But so we should take care of this clopidogrel or any cardiology patients who is using the proton pump inhibitors. And we have some minute side effects such as diarrhea. So this is a side effects of our proton pump inhibitors. So this is about proton pump inhibitors. Keep following. Thank you.